Hello friends, this video on cubes and cube roots part 2 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us talk about the properties of perfect cubes. Now since these numbers are special, they also have some special properties. So the first property is cubes of numbers with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 as the unit digits will end with 0, 1, 8, 7, 4, 5, 6, 3, 2, 9 respectively. Quite complicated statement, isn't it? Well, but it is actually not that complex. So what it tries to say is, let's say that I have given you some big number. Let's say I have given you a number like this, 723 to the power 3. And if I ask you that, can you tell me the result would end in what digit? That is, what would be the unit digit of its cube? Now, it's very difficult for you to tell because you just can't orally do the multiplication of 723 into 723 into 723. That's difficult. So for that, what you can do is you can apply this logic. So we know the cubes of numbers from 1 to 10, right? So we basically know the values of the first 10 perfect cubes. And knowing these is more than enough to predict the unit digit of cube of any number. How? That's because the unit, just focus on the unit digit of the number. Now this unit digit has to be one of the digits between 0 to 9. It has to be one of those digits, right? So what is the unit's digit here? So here the unit's digit is 3. So when you look at these values, cube of 3 is 27. Right? So that shows that when you actually when you do actual multiplication, that is when you multiply 723 with 723 and then again you multiply the product with 723, you would see that during the process of actual multiplication, what happens is the unit's digit of the result is equal to the unit's digit of the product of the unit's digit of the number. That is, if 3 cube is equal to 27, where 7 is the unit's digit, that means that when you find out its cube, the unit's digit will be 7. So in the result also, the unit's digit would be 7. So that is why we say that cubes of any number which ends with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, their product or their cubes would end in these numbers, because 10 cube is 1000. So any number ending with 0, its cube will also end with 0. Any number ending with 1, its cube will end with 1. Any number ending with 2, cube will end with 2. Any number ending with 3, cube will end with 7, and so on. So just by knowing the cubes of the first 10 numbers, you can actually predict the unit's digit of the cube of any number. Cubes of even numbers are even. This is another interesting thing. So when you look at the pattern here, at least the first few perfect cubes pattern, you would see that any number which is even, even means the number which is completely divisible by 2. So here the even numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So these are the even numbers. So when you look at their cubes, the values are 8, 64, 216, 512, and 1000, and all of these are even again. So cubes of even numbers are always even. Similarly, cubes of odd numbers are odd. That's because the numbers like 3, 5, 7, 9, they are odd numbers and their cubes are also odd.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.